Dear friends, it is an honor to be addressing the 6th Indo-Japan Samvad Conference. 5 years ago, we began this series of conferences with former Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. Since then, Samvad has traveled from New Delhi to Tokyo, from Yangon to Ulaanbaatar. In this journey, it has remained true to its fundamental objectives: to encourage dialogue and debate, to highlight our shared values of democracy, humanism, ahimsa, freedom and tolerance, and to carry forward our ancient tradition of spiritual and scholarly exchanges. I would like to thank the government of Japan for their constant support to Samvad. Friends, this forum has done great work to ensure, promote the ideas and ideals of Lord Buddha, especially among the youth. Historically, the light of Buddha's message spread out from India to many parts of the world. However, this light did not remain static. In each new place it reached, Buddhist thought continued to evolve further over the centuries. Because of this, great treasures of Buddhist literature and philosophy can be found in many different monasteries across many different countries and languages. This body of writing is a treasure of humankind as a whole. Today, I would like to propose the creation of a library of all such traditional Buddhist literature and scriptures. We will be happy to create such a facility in India and will provide appropriate resources for it. The library will collect digital copies of all such Buddhist literature from different countries. It will aim to translate them and make them freely available to all monks and scholars of Buddhism. The library will not only be a depository of literature, it will also be a platform for research and dialogue, a true samvad between human beings, between societies, and between man and nature. Its research mandate will also include examining how Buddhist message can guide our modern world against contemporary challenges. Challenges like poverty, racism, extremism, gender discrimination, climate change, and many others. Friends, about 3 weeks ago, I was at Sarnath. Sarnath is where Lord Buddha gave his first sermon after attaining enlightenment. This Jyoti Punj emerged from Sarnath, spread across the world, embracing the value of compassion, nobility, and above all, Manav Kalyan, the good of entire humanity. And gently, peacefully, it changed the course of world history. It was in Sarnath that Lord Buddha spoke in detail about this ideal of Dhamma. Dhamma for him was more than a prayer and rituals. At the center of Dhamma are humans and the relation with fellow humans. Thus, it is most important to be a positive force in the lives of others. Samvad should be one that will spread the spirit of positivity, unity, and compassion across our planet. That too at a time when we need it the most. Friends, this is the first Samvad of a new decade. It is happening at a critical moment of human history. Our actions today will shape the discourse in the coming times. This decade and beyond will belong to these societies that place a premium on learning and innovating together. It will be about nurturing bright young minds who will add value to the humanity in the times to come. Learning should be such that furthers innovation. After all, innovation is the cornerstone of human empowerment. Societies that are open-minded, democratic and transparent are better suited to innovate. Therefore, now is the time, more than ever before, to change the paradigm on what we see as growth. Discussions on global growth cannot happen only between a few. The table must be bigger. The agenda must be broader. Growth patterns must follow a human-centric approach and be in harmony with our surroundings. Friends, it is rightly mentioned in the Yamak Bhaggo Dhammapada. Nahi beren berani sammantit kudachan averena cha sammanti esha dhammo sandantano. Hostility will never achieve peace. In the past, humanity took the path of confrontation instead of collaboration. From imperialism to the world wars, from the arm race to the space race. We had a dialogues, but they were aimed at pulling others down. Now, let us rise together. Lord Buddha's teachings command the strength to turn the discourse from enmity to empowerment. His teachings make us large-hearted. They tell us, learn from the past and work towards a better future. This is the best service we can do for our future generations. Friends, the essence of Samvad remains togetherness. Let Samvad bring out the best in us together. This is the time to draw upon our ancient values and prepare for the times to come. We must keep humanism at the core of our policies. We must make harmonious coexistence with nature at the central pillar of our existence. Samvad, a dialogue with ourselves. with fellow human beings and with nature can light our way on this path. I compliment the organizers for organizing this important event and wish them all success in their deliberations. Thank you.
और खबरों के लिए टीवी वन इंडिया को सब्सक्राइब करें और नोटिफिकेशन पाने के लिए बेल आइकॉन को दबाना मत भूलें।